Две минуты. Last week we read that when Moshe Rabbeinu, at the end of the parasha, he comes to Paro, right? Finally Hashem, he convinced Moshe to go, and Moshe goes to Paro. And Paro said, I see you guys are a little bit lazy from work, I'll give you more work, and you won't ask to leave Mitzrayim. And Moshe Rabbeinu comes back to Hashem, and he says, Hashem, lama arot elam azeh, why did you do bad to this nation? So Hashem answers him back, and he says, v'edaber elokim Moshe, v'ayom elam ani Hashem. Elohim answers back Moshe and he says, Ani Hashem. How do you have in one pasuk two names of Hashem? You have Elohim and Hashem. And Rashi says, Elohim means Hashem spoke toughly with Moshe, harshly. So, Moshe, how can you even judge me on what I do? Who are you? You're nobody. You're just a human being. I'm Hashem. But in the end of the pasuk, he says, Ani Hashem. Elohim is Din, Hashem is Rachamim, right? So what is Hashem want from Moshe? Are you Din or you Rachamim? What are you trying to do over here? So Chavetz Chaim says an amazing lesson over here. He says, Hashem wants to show a lesson to Moshe Rabbeinu. He says, everything you see in life, it might seem Elohim, right? But in the end, if you look in the end of the story, it's all, it says Hashem. I mean, it's all Rachamim, it's all with mercy. Moshe Rabbeinu, what does Hashem tell Moshe Rabbeinu? He said, you just see one side of the story. The other side of the story, you don't see. What's the other side of the story? He said, they're supposed to be in Mitzrayim 400 years. Some say 430 years. Some say 400 years. But they're only 410 years. I made the suffering great. Why? Because I wanted to make them leave early. Right? He said, this is what Moshe Rabbeinu did not understand. And this was the first lesson that Moshe had in his life. That's why the Pasuk says, Vayomer, it says here, Vayomer Elohim, Vaydabir Elohim Moshe. Hashem says, first, whatever happens to person, it's Elohim. It starts with Din. But in the end, it says, Vayom Elav Ani Hashem. But in the end of the story, it says, it will be Ani Hashem. So Moshe Rabbeinu learned the lesson here that nothing from Hashem is bad. Everything is good. That's what Chavetz Chaim says, that when you praise Hashem, either it's good or bad in Masechet Brachot. Why you praise Hashem when it's bad? If it's bad, you don't praise Hashem. Just because it's bad. Chavetz Chaim says, because in our eyes it looks bad, but in Hashem's eyes it all looks good. That's why even if it's bad, you bless Hashem that it's all good. That's why it says over here, Ani Hashem.